Hi everyone, this is Connelly Gonzalez and welcome to your Information Security Newspaper channel. Today we will talk about Zoom, a video conferencing platform, which is one of the most popular apps on both the App Store and Google Play. Only a few days ago, the biggest leaders from the world held a G20 meeting through Zoom to discuss the COVID-19 pandemic. And many important meetings have been held through Zoom in the last few days because of the quarantine. Even though recently it had been found the Zoom app for iOS had been sharing analytics data with Facebook. The loophole was exposed only a few days ago, and since then, the app worked hard to quickly fix it. Apparently, what was being shared were when the user opened the app, and details like the time zone, city, details on the device. Actually, this has not been the first time that Zoom has been accused of invading privacy. In 2019, a webcam hacking scandal where Zoom was involved was exposed. At that time, there was a Zoom vulnerability that left the host exposed to attacks. This flaw allowed webcams to be activated via ghost Zoom call. We made a video about it and you can see it here. And of course, hackers are now crashing Zoom conferences. And sometimes they are not there just to snoop, but they take over control and share inappropriate images. This is also known as Zoom bombing. The University of Massachusetts held a Zoom conference a few days ago, and the conference was Zoom bombed. Hackers displayed racist slurs and graphic imagery. Incidents of Zoom bombing are becoming more and more common. They usually consist of racist slurs and adult images being broadcast over a Zoom conference.
Yo, Aaron, you're so fucking fat. You're a nasty fat pig. Hey,
Natasha,
Brianna.
You look like a boy.
All the girls here are ugly and nasty.
Also, hackers are usually verbally attacking the members of these conferences. As a result to this, some schools have already decided not to use Zoom for their video conferences. So here we will tell you 5 ways to protect your meeting from hackers. Number 1, always disable guest screen sharing. If only the host can share his or her screen, it's easier to prevent someone else from sharing inappropriate material. Number 2, don't start the meeting until the host is present. Zoom provides the option to start the meeting as soon as the first person gets there, even if the host is not there. However, if you want to protect these meetings, it's better to turn this option off. That way, you'll know that no one can start the meeting without you. Not even a hacker or a Zoom bomber. Yes, we are calling them that now. Number 3, always keep your meeting ID private. Never share your meeting ID on social media. If you do, it's very easy for anyone to join the meeting you are hosting. Instead, use a unique meeting ID for each meeting you host. This is a good way to keep away intruders. Number 4, use a password to enter your meeting. You can always enable the feature in Zoom that protects your meeting with a password, and only share the password with the people you want in your meeting. Number 5, take advantage of the waiting room. Zoom has an option to enable a waiting room where it places every one of your guests on a virtual waiting room. When you start a meeting, you will have to manually accept every one of your members one by one. But this is probably the most reliable option to know who gets in. While I'm sure you will find this information useful, share it with whoever you think it can help. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe and click the bell button. My name is Connelly Gonzalez and I wish you the very best.